Hello everyone, this is Erxalis speaking. I have changed my look so I look even more awesome, and Drew is testing his new experimental Melee Ranger build. This video is the first in the new series. The series is called Incremental Evolution, and it is designed to show us what we do well and what we do wrong, basically, so by watching videos we can learn from our mistakes. The focus is, of course, on group tactics, not individual skills. There are many awesome videos in the internet which show individual skills of great players, but much less about tactics with commentary. If you attack an enemy camp, first look around. Ambush is a very powerful and potent weapon in Guild Wars 2. When I down an assaulter, the necromancer has proper instincts. Start reviving ASAP, but without interrupting, stomping will be faster. The warrior either didn't notice me or ignored me. The necromancer focused on the supervisor while I was able to walk on a warrior. Either the warrior shouldn't fight me but should attack the supervisor, or the necromancer should attack me, not the supervisor. They didn't have teamwork, so they didn't have any type of force multiplier. This could end only in one way. By the way, here I shouldn't have attempted to stomp. Look at my hit points. I have lost half of them on unsuccessful stomp. I should have rolled back and cast a warden on the downed invader. That would force the necromancer to either heal his ally or to attack me. Sadly, I didn't do any of those things, and I stood there taking several hits like a fool, and this in the end cost me victory in this battle. If they worked as a team, not as three individuals, in the moment I attacked them from ambush, I would get massacred. And this is where we failed our teamwork. Look at the minimap, please. There are two people in front of me and two people behind me. We already engaged the enemy. At this point we don't know how many enemies are there, but they are in one group. We attack in the snake formation. We don't really call targets and we don't communicate well. As you can see, even if we manage to down one enemy, it doesn't really matter. A downed elementalist can always hide underwater, while our downed can't. As we weren't together, I didn't know who downed Drew, thus I couldn't use temporal curtain, I didn't know that there is an invisible thief. From this point, it could only go one way. What should we have done? First of all, we would have waited until the whole team assembles. Then, they might attack us, and they might attack us not as a team, but as a mob, in the snake formation. Would we win? No idea, but we would have a chance. Playing like this, we couldn't have won ever. By contrast, here we've done everything right. Pulls and immobilizes, a moment later, heavy blinds and chills from Ailey in the plague form, calling targets, focusing fire. I mean, even if individually it wasn't the best performance ever, I didn't use the defender, got controlled a bit. Doesn't really matter. Teamwork and team actions are enough to mitigate the individual failures of individual people in the team. This is 4 of us versus 5 of them, and a guard. If you look at our hit points, you won't see it. We aren't endangered a bit. We left one downed behind, so we make a pressure on them, and moved forward to destroy others. We didn't want them to escape. It's a bit counterintuitive, but we could afford this, seeing how great advantage we had at that moment in fight. Still, it was a bit risky. We have spread fire a bit, which isn't the best thing we could have done. This time warp here should come far, far earlier. Please notice how I use it to stomp an enemy. All types of quickness are great in stomping because players usually remember how much time do they have, and this messes with the timings. Now we just had to kill the remaining one, and the battle was won quite easily. Ailey is a control necromancer with wells and the plague form, and she made it far easier than it should be. This clip shows how to use terrain to make a death trap. It is a 5 versus 3 fight, so they don't have a chance on pure numbers,
but it has the best opener I have ever seen. The enemies had to move through this particular choke point, so we had crate drop from the engineer there, Ailey with her blinds and chills, time warp to accelerate the damage. When an enemy got downed there, his allies had two choices: stay in the most unfavorable terrain ever, or run away and let him be stomped. Let's assume you've got enemies which are hidden inside a camp which has Righteous Indignation buff at the supervisor. It doesn't mean you are helpless though. You can always try an assassination. Supervisor is the only dangerous enemy then. Supervisor tends to focus on one player only, the one with higher toughness or something. If you locate which player is it, the player can dance a supervisor and the rest of the team can try assassination. If you are a target of an assassination, try to hug supervisor as close as possible and try to maneuver enemies onto the guards, immobilize them and pull them. If you manage to find which player is being targeted by supervisor, try to immobilize that particular player. That means supervisor may manage to kill him. And this is where I am a target of assassination. As I tend to play very aggressively, I have attacked 3 players, always hoping I will be able to return to a camp. Sadly, my enemies had a bit different idea about fighting. By this I mean Moa. Moa, why? I'm alone, there are 3 of them! Don't misunderstand me, if I was in their place, I would totally do the same. Here you can see an incredibly awesome save by Camaville with Shadow Refuge. And if I would attack them, using the auto attack, I would reveal myself and the thief would be able to stomp me. Conversely, if they wanted to save their thief ally, they could have Shadow Refuged him, but they didn't. What began as a conflict between 3 of us and 3 Whiteside invaders escalated into a small-scale war. A Total Annihilation reference. Although Vlado changed target, with Alaric we stayed on the Guardian and managed to kill him. In the meantime, Vlado managed to heavily damage a thief and we got an assistance from another player. While we were mopping up the remaining engineer, a moment later Whiteside reinforcements appeared, and it quickly became a fight of more or less 4 of us, while one person is not in the party, versus 8 of them. Well, we are close to a spawn anyway, so we decided to stay on a target and fight. Engineers, if built that way, tend to be very hard to down though, so the target was quickly lost. I got very heavily pressured here, so my main priority was not to down an engineer, but not to get downed myself, because knowing Alaric and Flutter, they would try to put me up, which would doom the team. Alaric took advantage of the fact that enemies were not really focusing any of us, pulled them to himself, and made the Guardian Swirl Something ability, and downed 2 of them. Although Whiteside players started to resurrect their fallen allies, Flutter managed to stomp one of them. Sadly, the other stood up. When I got downed, the 4th player, Vulneraria, also a Guardian, used the Guardian bubble and used this time to get me up as well. One Whitesider stomped a clone, and Flutter dropped the crate to help me in standing up. Please notice the amount of crowd control which is being used during this battle. This is why, even with their superior numbers, we can still stand alive. Another player got killed right now, and the 5th Gurnarholdian joined the party. If you look at their hit points and our hit points, we are winning the war of attrition. I am not exactly sure why. Judging from Alaric's hit points, I think some water fields and blast finishers were used. I don't really know. At this stage of the fight is already won for our side. They have low hit points, we are almost full on hit points, and we are mopping them up. Even if the tide turns, we can always retreat to the camp. I have to admit I can't really make an analysis of this fight, because I was so focused on staying alive that my camera didn't catch all those small differences which made this fight won. I hope when I ask Alaric and Flutter, they will see something I don't in this fight. There is simply no better way to open a clip than by two thieves from different servers trying to kill you. Still, target is set, in front of us only Black Tide, so let us go. It's better not to split during the fight, because if we are together, then the others, not downed players, can get you up. Now, a moment of indecision, no target is set, everyone probes enemies, searching for one with low hit points, and in a moment target will be selected again. Unless, of course, someone gets downed, like me, for example. Flutter instantly started to heal me, and I used the down skill number 2 to move. There is one invisible thief, so he may try to stomp me. Afterwards, we both took up Alaric. During this time, enemies, having their own downed, didn't try to res them. This allowed the four of us to get a kill. Once again, probing for a low hit point target and target selection. Flutter selected an enemy Mesmer, who earlier proved not to be in a defensive tanky build. With three people focusing one Mesmer, he has to fall, not using invisibility skills, and we are able to destroy him. Flutter uses area of effect where he should appear, and I stray towards the white side thieves to drive them off from us, so we can finish the execution of a Mesmer. Another selected target is also a Mesmer, but this one used invisibility skill where he should. When I spotted him in the distance, I reacquired the target, and we swooped upon him. Having no hit points at all, he didn't have any chance to survive the encounter. And this ends the clip, which says, "Why should you stay together to get resurrected by allies?"